Okay, folks, if you'd give me your attention for about 5 minutes. Yeah, it's not going to be anything you haven't necessarily seen before, but I do want to remind folks that there's an outstanding call for proposals to be release manager for 3.5. The deadline for making submissions is arbitrarily set at precisely midnight at 59 seconds on Friday Eastern time. But basically, what I'm hoping will happen, and I already know that there's at least one nascent proposal, is that this go-around will explicitly try the experiment of having co-RMs, by which I mean two people with the responsibility for project planning, such as it is, leadership, boosting the abilities, but in a mode where one person who has done it before is helping teach the co-RM the tips and the tricks. And of course, while in theory you can be release manager without pushing a single patch during the cycle, that's probably not the best way of doing it. But there are just a lot of details about how you deal with the various scenarios, such as putting in database schema updates, dealing with the backboarding, and so on. That is a lot of unwritten lore that probably, if not get written down, at least knowledge of how you do it will work and shared and the more broadly. Like I said, I know that is one nascent proposal, but I do encourage people to think about putting in a proposal, because an actual election would not be a bad thing. But that said, one proposal comes across and it's a solid, great. If there are multiple, then I think next Wednesday is the time I said for us to hold an election. This is also an opportunity for folks to propose changes to the overall process. I know a couple of years ago, we had intentionally made the point that a release manager need not be a core committer. They just need to be somebody in a position to advocate for the release and help push things along. Now, while of course having the commitment can be helpful for that, particularly in terms of credibility, isn't actually a requirement. And also to kind of tie back to part of my presentation yesterday, whatever happens, we don't want the release manager to become the bottleneck per se, or the sole person who's expected to push all of the patches. So that's kind of my basic pitch. Some of it early, some of it often. If you're submitting early and often, because you've managed to successfully clone yourself and all of your clones are in agreement about working on nothing but Evergreen, so much the better. So any questions about this? Never go get the IRC one night. Any questions about that? Any thoughts about RM changes in general that people would like to see for the next cycle? Anything like that?
Are we? We're otherwise sticking with the build master style, where people elect to the builds for different distros and things like that.
I think nowadays the question of the build master is kind of separate. So okay. There's kind of a self-organizing team of folks that do it.
There's obviously overlap between those positions.
Okay. Yeah.
So as part of, just so I understand, because I'm considering putting a proposal to be a co, somewhat senior, is the expectation is that you got the release from the point where it's starting to coalesce into, you know, the actual release through its entire life cycle and security updates. So this is basically a year and a half commitment, is that right?
It can be. It doesn't necessarily have to, but yeah, it has been the pattern in the past that the release manager will take kind of release maintenance responsibility ongoing to the end of the security support. So that's certainly a useful way to think of it, but it's not really a set in stone that can make that. It is also perfectly acceptable to say, okay, somebody I'm not taking care of the 15 that had, say, needed to step aside and look for somebody else to help by take on ongoing maintenance release, right?
And once the release is done and the first round of bug squashing is done, at that point it's considerably less involvement required.
Probably also a good idea to mention some of the specific things that the release manager has historically done. One is guiding the roadmap, just flagging entries for it, setting the release schedule. So that's making the decisions about whether to do now, when to cut a beta, when to cut a release a candidate, and so on. And then remind people of those other lines, and also encourage people working on specific important bugs or features to meet those other lines. The release manager or the release manager team is also empowered, particularly at the end of the release cycle, to be the final arbiter if there's a question about whether something should because, of course, there's always kind of fine balance, especially at the final scrap or less good enough to make the can reasonably be good enough, like not one release versus we'll make. Another thing you can do is not written in a stone, but even though it's my idea, I don't kind of recommend it. I do recommend continuing the practice of feedback and status. If for no other reason than that you historically have been times where the patches actually get merged. So any other questions from the group? Let's see. Yes, I'm not. So thank you for your time.
Thanks, Scott.